Hello, wherever you are, and welcome to our today's class. We are going to discuss about characteristics of radio. As we know, radio is a medium of communication that uses electronic means, and we say that radio is able to reach many people at the same time due to its simplicity. So when you're talking about characteristics of radio, if you're a radio producer or a radio presenter or a radio news reporter, there are some aspects of radio that you must always put in mind. Number one, we are saying that radio makes pictures. Despite the fact that radio uses audio as a form of communication, when you are communicating by use of radio, we must see pictures in your communication, because radio is only effective if the listener is able to picture or raise to contextualize what you are talking in terms of pictures or in terms of diagrams. If you are communicating by use of audio as a form of communication, we need to see whatever you are talking about in terms of images or in terms of pictures. We are talking about an accident that took place at a specific time. We need to see the imagery of what transpired or else of what happened during that particular accident. So you are saying that radio makes pictures or else speaks in pictures. The second characteristic of radio is that it speaks to millions. That's why you'll find that if you have a very high frequency of your radio transmission, you are able to reach a wider audience at the same time. And even in the current generation, whereby you are living in the digital world, many people are using digital medium as a form of communication in terms of radio, whereby you can open up your online radio station and you are able to reach many people across the globe or across the world. That's why you are saying that it speaks to millions. Many people can be able to listen to radio at the same time. Then we are saying that when you're using radio as a form of communication, it addresses an individual. That's why we normally say, dear listener, not listeners. Because you're addressing an individual, you assume that you are talking to one person. Despite the fact that you're addressing millions of people outside there, but you're using radio as a medium of communication, it is an interpersonal communication whereby you have you as at the send of the message who is in the studio and have the recipient or raise your audience who is getting your content. So you address radio by use of as a single individual, not as a multitude or as not as a complex population. So when you are communicating by use of radio, you are going to say dear listener, not listeners. Then you are having what is called the speed. Radio is always efficient, whereby once you disseminate the message in the studio, someone is listening to that particular message immediately when you are communicating or when you are addressing them. That's why I say that radio is very quick in dissemination of information. You don't have to, like, for example, someone is sending a letter or is by use of a post office. You have to wait maybe for 2 days, 2 weeks for you to be able to get the content of communication. The same principle applies to newspapers. You must go and buy the newspaper, maybe the newspaper vendor, for you to be able to go to get the news. But in radio, the communication is very effective because when the message is sent, it is received immediately by your targeted audiences. Then you are saying that radio has no boundaries. Provided you have your frequencies well laid and you have purchased adequate frequencies that is able to cover a wider area or a wider audience, you are going to be able to reach a wider audiences, and there is no way you can be able to block the frequencies of the radio station unless it is done so by the concerned parties. So, despite the fact that radio is very speed and effective in communication, radio is also cheap. As compared to television, radio is cheap because once you buy your radio, you can use it, you can even buy a small radio, and you are still able to get the content or else get the information just as someone who is using a bigger radio. The same principle applies to when you are comparing radio and television. Television is a bit more expensive, and many people are not able to afford to buy television. But very many people are able to purchase radio as compared to TV, or else as compared to newspaper or magazines, which are very expensive medium of communication. So there is simplicity of radio. Radio is cheap, and you are saying radio has no boundaries. Last but not least, you are saying that radio can easily be understood by people raised by your targeted audiences. More so if you are using, let's say, local radio stations, whereby these people understand the vernacular, the language you're communicating, and you can easily be effective in your communication. So as compared to most of the TV stations that are majorly national TV stations, we have so many local radio stations that are able to communicate different messages to different targeted audiences by use of vernacular languages or by use of local languages. And out of that, many people are likely to get what we are trying to communicate or raise what you are communicating to them. So I hope you are able to understand some of the major characteristics of radio in the society. We say that radio makes pictures, whereby when you are talking, we need to see the imagery aspect of what you are talking about. We talked about it speaks to million, or as varied population, or as diverse population at the same time. We said you are addressing an individual, not a population. We say radio is speed, or as it is quick in dissemination of the content, and we said it has no boundaries. We have said that radio is cheap, and last but not least, we say that the simplicity of radio in terms of communication, in terms of affordability. Thank you for your time. Let's meet next time at the same place.